Hello everyone, so this is a second part of basic follower motions in Kamen follower mechanism. So in today's motion, we are going to discuss about simple harmonic motion. So this is the second part and the discussion was simple harmonic motion. It means the follower will follow a path, or the motion of the follower will be having a nature of simple harmonic motion nature, right? So how did we define the simple harmonic motion? We even have a graphical representation, right? So that graphical representation is going to be shown out right now. So this is our y-axis. And from this itself, we are going to derive the equations required. Okay, this is your y-axis. And then we are going to have the x-axis. And we are going to only define the motion for the rise part, because the return part will be similar to the rise part. And one second. Let me draw it big enough. Yeah. So now, simple harmonic motion is a motion where you see that there is a particle on a circle, right? It seems like there is a particle on the circle. Fine. And we trace the particle on the y-axis. We trace the path of the particle on y-axis. Okay, we can trace it on y or x-axis. So that is your simple harmonic motion in your common context. So right now we are going to take only half of the circle on that side to trace the simple harmonic motion. Okay, so we are going to take half of the path while we are tracing the simple harmonic motion. Yes, so that part we are going to take to trace the simple harmonic motion, and the diameter will be equal to the total lift. So until now I think we are used to the terminology lift. Lift is the total height which is raised by the follower. That is your lift, okay? And so I'm going to show the lift from here to here, and which will be equal to the diameter, okay? Let's take this one to show properly. This is your diameter D, or the total lift is the diameter. Lift is equal to diameter. So this is your diameter, total lift of the follower. Now what we do is, suppose you have rise from here to here, this is theta rise. I'm only going to define for theta rise. So we are going to divide the cam rotation. This theta is represented for cam rotation, right? So this is the cam rotation theta along the theta x-axis. So this is theta axis right now, and this is y-axis. Along y-axis is the lift. So right now we are going to divide the rise into six equal parts. So divide the rise into six equal parts. So this one, and this one. Yes. So we say this is zeroth position, first position, second, third, fourth, fifth, and theta rise is sixth position. Okay. So these are the six positions. And even the circle also we are going to divide into six parts. Fine. This is the center. Right. And then we have this one. So six parts, it is like 180 by six. So 30 each. Okay, each between adjacent lines, the angle will be 30 degrees. So let's say that these are equal number of parts divided even on the circle. So we give it numbers. Okay, I'll just give it numbers like 1-2-3-4-5-6-. Now what you do is, from one draw vertical line, and from 1- draw horizontal line. So horizontal line from 1-, horizontal from 1-, and vertical from 1. Then vertical from 2, and horizontal you have 2-, right? 2-, horizontal. And then from 3, you can draw a horizontal line, 3-, and this vertical line. I hope you are following the point. Yes, and then from 4, draw a vertical line, and from 4 dash, draw a horizontal line. Then 5 dash, horizontal, 5, vertical. Fine. And then finally, the 6, this is the highest point to be reached, right? Yes, and then from theta RI position, draw a vertical line. So wherever they are coinciding, just mark those points. Yes, just mark those points properly. So over here, I have marked it. Fine. And this is one point, and this is one point, then point, one more point, one more point, and one more point. And just connect it with a smooth curve from 0, 0 position. So connect it with a smooth curve. Yes. So this is your uniform velocity, simple harmonic motion. Sir, how can I imagine this motion? So you can imagine it such a way that, see, these points are the trace of what, your roller center, right? So you can imagine it in this way. See, for example, you have a roller. You can imagine that this is the position of the roller center. Okay, gradually, this is also the position of roller center. This is also the position of roller center. Okay, this is also the position of roller center. It means roller, is it going up or not? Yes, as the cam is rotating, roller is going up, right? How much up did it go? It went till the final lift position, which is this position. Yes, so this is actually the position of your roller itself. I hope you understood, right? So the cam is lifting from 0 position, which is on the horizontal, as the theta is rotating for such angle. Okay, there is some angle and theta is rotating for that some angle. Fine. So based on that angle, automatically you are having the lift of the follower. Fine. And what is the next position? Usually we have the next position, right? So the next position is, let's extend this line. Fine. And let's divide this part, this side part also. So let's say this is dual one. Fine. And then you have, this is return till here, from here to here. And then let's say that this is dual two. And here also divide it in number of parts. Let's right away divide it with these lines itself. So let's say this is the middle. And this side we have two divisions. See, this side also I'm doing the same thing, but I'm doing it in a faster manner. Fine. Just dividing it into equal parts. And then what we do? Number it again. Like this is 6. See, this is dual period till here. So this is theta D1 till here. And from here, you again number it like 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0. Fine, like 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We number it. And again, you extend the lines. See, from 6, 6 dash. So this is the point, 6 dash 6. Yeah. And then from 5 dash, just extend the line from 5 dash, wherever it cuts the 5 line. And then extend this wherever it cuts the, sorry, that is the 6 line, right? Which I showed you earlier. So we need to cut it on the 5 line over here. Then this is on the 4 dash 4. And this is 3 dash 3. Equal number of parts we need to divide, but here it's not shown properly, right? It's not looking like equal number of parts. Hope you're understanding. Yes, 1 dash 1. Yes, it's the same whatever we did there. Here also the same thing, but here I did the complete linings. So now join all these points with a smooth curve in the downward position. So this is a point, this is a point, and then you have another point here, 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 and finally 0 position, right? So now here it's constant, and then gradually, see, if the lines are far, you're not going to get a smoother curve. Okay. If the lines are close by, it means number of divisions you take, you will get very smooth curve. So this is simple harmonic motion. Okay. Now to understand this way, it's well and good, but mathematical equation is required. how do we write the mathematical equation? For further analysis, we need mathematical equation. Okay, so this way you can easily complete. So for example, you will get total lift of the follower. Total lift will be given of the follower. For example, it is 25 mm. Total lift of the follower is 25 mm, right? So you will draw a line, vertical line with 25 mm distance, and then draw a semicircle with center, like 12.5 is the center, right? Draw a semicircle and then divide it into parts. Then they will say that theta rise is 125 degrees, theta return is something. So this way, now what you need to do, theta rise, it means on horizontal, you have to divide it into equal number of parts, like 6 parts. Take equivalent length and divide it into 6 parts. Fine. So that way you can solve the problem. Like if it is 125, take 12.5, no problem. You can take 12.5, or you can take, take it in radians or pi by 180. So whichever is convenient, no problem. Based on that, you can take it. Yes. And then you can complete it. It's better to take in degrees itself. Okay. If it is 125, take the proper measurements, and based on that, you can calculate the RI, RE and all these things. Okay. For now, we are just discussing about the how to write the equation. Okay, in the coming videos, maybe we'll solve even problems based on this. For now, we are kind of learning about the equation. Now, how to write the equation? So, to write the equation, first, the follower is rising from zero to some position, right? Let's take some intermediate position. I'm taking position, this position, like 0.2. I'm taking this position, okay? So from base, this is the height, right? It rising, so that height is y. I'm calling it y because y is equal to 0 at the bottom, y is equal to l at the top, total rise, okay? So as that is the equation which we are going to do. Now, while the semicircle, see from here it started, right? The semicircle started from here, it came till here, okay? From the starting position, it came to here, this position. So I'll say that this angle turned is phi. Right, and I will say that as we have y equation will be the radius is l by 2, right? So I can say that this total length is y, right? So if I say this total length minus this length, is it y or not? See, this total length is l by 2 minus this length, right? Is it y? Y is equal to L by 2 minus, what is this length? So this length is equal to this length, right? What is this? The radius is L by 2. So it is L by 2 cos phi. I hope you understood how I wrote this y. How to get this y value? This y value will be gained by writing total length from this half portion, L by 2 minus L by 2 cos phi. Done. So I'm going to remove this. And directly I'm going to write the equation, okay? From the diagram, I'm going to remove all this. Yes. So y is equal to L by 2 minus L by 2 cos phi. Now, what is phi? Phi in terms of, I need in terms of L and theta RI. I want in those terms. So what I do is theta turned and all these things. So what I do is, see, as phi is reaching, tending to pi. Pi is what? See, phi from here to here, what is the angle? 180 degrees, right? As phi is going to pi, I will say that theta is going to theta RI. Can I say that? Yes or no? Theta is going to theta RI. Just think about it. Think about it. So now I am saying that as phi is tending to pi, it means on this semicircle, theta is going to theta RI, right? Because this is the highest position. See, lowest position of theta is this, zero. Highest position theta RI. In middle you say theta, right? So as theta, it means this is some theta, theta 2 is going to theta RI. I'll say phi is also this angle, is going to pi. So I'll say that phi is going to pi as theta is going to theta RI. In previously I explained, right, we can write this ratio as, I can even write like this, as pi is going to phi, theta is going to theta RI. So I can write phi value as pi by theta RI into theta. Yes. Now substitute. If you want to substitute, you can substitute as theta is zero. Theta is zero, phi is zero, right? So theta is theta r, I substitute it, cancel it out. Theta r, theta r get cancelled. Phi is equal to pi. So this equation you can easily get. Now substitute this value which you got just now. Substitute this value. Where will you substitute? Substitute in the above equation. So if you substitute in the above equation, you will get y is equal to the general equation L by 2, take it common, 1 minus cos. In place of phi, I am going to place pi by theta ri into theta. So this is the general equation which we will be using, and this is valid between 0, means theta is in between 0 and theta ri, because it's only for rise. Written also it is the same equation but on the opposite side. Okay, it's going to go down, it will maintain the same conditions. Okay, but the theta will be there between theta ri and 0. It means just the opposite case. See, we started from here, right, going up like this. So if you calculate the equation starting like this, it will be the same as this equation. Okay, so that's why we are not going to calculate each and every equation. With this equation we are going to analyze each and everything. So the next analysis is, write down the general motion once again. What is the general motion? Y is equal to L by 2 into 1 minus cos of pi theta by theta ri. So this is the general equation which we got, like in previous case. Now again, we are going to check it for velocity. We are going to check it for acceleration also. So now we are going to check it for velocity and acceleration. Now to find out velocity, see, we have a velocity is dy by dt, right? With respect to time, it is rate of change, right? So with respect to time only, it is velocity. But here theta is variable on the RHS. So we want to differentiate with respect to theta. That's why what we do is we write dy by d theta. This is what I want to differentiate. But equivalent, I have to write what? For to write it as velocity, I need to do this, because d theta, d theta get cancelled, and dy by dt. So this is equal to what? Dy by d theta into omega. Omega is d theta by dt. Now I can differentiate it to get velocity. Okay, this is velocity now. This is actually velocity. So v is equal to, okay. So I can write down v is equal to omega into dy by dt. So just write L by 2. And if you do, the differentiate of constant is 0 and cos is minus sine, and internal derivative, see, I'll do sine pi theta by theta ri, and internal derivative is, do the internal derivative, you will get pi by theta ri outside, right? So finally the equation will be velocity is equal to omega L pi by 2 theta ri sine of pi theta by theta ri. So this is what we are getting as velocity equation. Now guys, tell me, will the L velocity be infinity anytime? Yes. See, velocity is maximum and minimum values. Right now we can see that, see, by telling that velocity is just in place of theta, you substitute different values. So whatever values you substitute, the sine value will be between minus 1 and plus 1, right? So you will get maximum value as minus omega L pi by 2 ri, and minimum value will be minus omega L by, minus omega L pi by 2 ri. This will be the minimum value. So these only, because sine will be maximum plus 1 and minimum minus 1. So when will it happen? When theta is equal to theta ri, what will happen? So you will have sine pi. So sine pi is sine 180 degrees. It will be minus 1. Fine. And sine 0. So you, for 0 to, if you want to get it as 0, so what do you do? So sine 90, sine 0 is 0, right? So theta is equal to 0 degrees. So in the beginning, you will have the 0 value, right? Velocity can never be infinite. It will have a definite value. Now to find out acceleration, the same thing you will follow, and you will find out the acceleration as, it will be d2y by dt2 will be equal to omega square d2y by d theta 2, sorry, it's d theta 2, which is equal to, I'll just write the final thing. You can just check, cross check it by doing it yourself. So you'll get this value, pi by theta ri whole squared cos pi theta by theta ri. So even here, you're getting the acceleration as always finite. Here you don't have any infinite acceleration like you got in the previous case. Okay, in previous case, you got infinite accelerations, right? Here you are not going to get any such type of values. So that is a very plus point. But the only problem is because you have a finite value, right? Because you have a finite value. So the next derivative, which is a jerk. Okay. So if you substitute theta is equal to zero over here. If you substitute theta is equal to zero, so you are going to get some value, right? It means acceleration in the beginning is constant. See, substitute theta equal to zero. So for theta is equal to zero, fine. What will be the acceleration? Acceleration will be, cos will be one, right? If it is zero, omega square L by 2 pi by theta ri. So if you are getting a constant value, what did we say in previous case? If you need constant velocity, acceleration is maximum. Acceleration is the next derivative of velocity, right? See, for constant velocity, acceleration is infinite. Now tell me, for constant acceleration, the next derivative is jerk. Jerk will be infinite. Remember that, because A is constant in the beginning, you will have infinite jerk. Okay, so you will have jerk, which is d3y by dt3 will tend to infinite. Okay, since acceleration is constant in the start. Okay, so this is what the complete analysis. Next, we are going into the graphs, how we are going to draw that velocity versus displacement and acceleration versus displacement, how we are going to represent it on a graph. Fine. And before that, you can check, we have drawn the rise, dwell, then return. See this part from here to here, this part is return period. Okay, theta ri, I didn't mention. And the starting part is theta ri, which I mentioned over here. This entire part is theta rise. Okay, theta rise, theta return, all these things are there, right? Hope you understood. This is theta rise. Fine, you call it theta rise, theta rise, rise, return, and then dwell one, and this is theta dwell two. Fine, let's continue. So now we are going to continue the class. We'll draw the displacement diagram. So first, the displacement diagram using the simple harmonic motion. So we have different parts. I'll just mark those parts. One is theta rise. The first part is taken under theta rise. So let's say that this is the theta rise from the beginning till here. Let's say that this is theta dwell. And let's say finally we got theta return and then dwell. I'm not drawing the dwell right now. And the total height, let's say that this is the total lift. Yes. And now you had a simple harmonic motion which looks something like this. Yes. So this was your simple harmonic motion, which is going quietly here. And then finally, yes, so this is your simple harmonic motion curve. So now, this is the total lift L and theta here. Yes, theta ri, theta re, dwell 1, and end dwell 2, theta dwell 2. And this is y, which is shown on the y-axis. Now we'll just extend this and find out the velocity curves. How are those going to look? Extend this further downwards. still going down. Okay, we'll try to make it as straight as possible. Yes, and this is what? This is for velocity and this is for acceleration, a horizontal line, okay? And right now, we know that this is for velocity and we know that we have even an equation, right? Equation for velocity, which we found out was V is equal to omega L by 2 to pi by theta ri multiplied by sine pi theta by theta ri. So this was the equation. Now, this is the position 0, right? When theta is equal to 0, this is the position where theta equal to theta ri, right? So when theta is equal to 0, it is sine 0. So this is the point. Sine 0 is 0, right? So V value is 0, velocity on the vertical axis. So vertical axis velocity is 0. Now try this value for theta equal to theta ri. I feel that we'll again get 0, right? Again, it is 0. But if theta equal to theta ri by 2, then you will get sine pi by 2, right? See carefully, theta equal to theta ri by 2. Now for theta equal to 0, I got V is equal to 0. Theta equal to theta ri by 2, I will get velocity as omega L by 2 pi by theta ri, because sine value will be equal to 1, because it is 90, sine 90. Fine. So it is sine 90, it is equal to 1, because it is theta ri by 2. Similarly, when so you will get maximum value. So this will be the value. Yes, that is the maximum value. So now you are going to get this curve for velocity profile. Fine. And now come to the other side. Other side, the angle is going on increasing, right? This is again, the angle is going on increasing. The same thing you are going to get on the other side. Fine. Maximum velocity, but it is a on the other side because the direction of velocity is downwards. So you'll get in the downward direction. So these are the maximum velocities, and maximum velocity is what? Omega L pi by 2 ri. And even you can check for theta equal to theta ri, you are going to get again V is equal to 0. Fine. So these are the values for velocity. Now, after velocity, we are going to get into acceleration also, right? So now what is acceleration? Acceleration equation also was previously derived, right? So acceleration equation was derived, and acceleration is equal to omega square L by 2 into pi by theta ri whole squared multiplied by cos pi theta by theta ri. If you check this equation out, at 0, at A is equal to 0, or sorry, at theta is equal to 0. So cos 0 is 1, right? So you'll get value of A is equal to omega square L by 2 multiplied by pi by theta ri whole square. This is the value. It means at initial, this is acceleration. Initially at 0 degrees itself, you have a value. Fine. Let's take the value a little down for our convenience. So you have a value already. It means from 0 directly you came up with a value. Okay, it's not without a value. It is having a value. Acceleration of the follower is having already a predefined constant value at this position. Done. And now after this, let's come to theta ri by 2. Okay, because theta ri 2 by 2, earlier also it was making some difference, right? So theta ri by 2, you can see that when theta is equal to theta ri by 2, just substitute it over there, you will get as cos pi. And what is cos pi? Cos pi is cos 180. And cos 180, does it have any value? It is 0, right? Yes. Is it 0 or does it have some value? Be alert, guys, please be alert. Is cos pi 0? And actually, do you get cos pi over there? No, right? So theta ri by 2, so theta ri get, can you get cos pi by 2? Cos pi by 2 is 90 and it is equal to 1. Cos pi by 2 is what? 90 and it is equal to 0. So cos 90 is 0, right? So you are going to get value as 0. Fine. So you will have acceleration to be equal to zero. Just you can pause it and think about it. You will get the point. So exactly at the midpoint, cos value is, so the acceleration is zero. And check it for at theta ri. So it is cos 180. So cos 180, which is cos pi. So you'll get at theta is equal to, again, theta ri, you will get a is equal to negative of omega square l by 2 into pi by theta ri whole squared. So you're going to get a negative value in the same, with the same value. So this curve will follow something like this. This is your acceleration value, and you don't have anywhere infinite acceleration, okay? Similarly, you will follow the same thing in the opposite side also. Fine? Yes. Similarly, same thing you're going to follow in the opposite, sorry, the other side also while return. It just changes its directions, right? Yes. It's like in mirror image. Acceleration is like mirror image. And that, yeah, same thing is following even on the other side. Fine. If you put on those values, you are going to get this curve. If you put theta return values and all, you are going to get these curves with the equation which is measured from the other side. Fine. Okay, guys, then I hope you understood clearly. Yes. How we are going to draw the velocity, acceleration, and how are we going to draw the curves and all, and where is the position of the follower. Yes. Okay, then thank you. In the next video, we will meet with the next type of motion.